waging war on corruption. Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. Big Brother, mainstream media, government cover-ups. You want answers? Well, so does he. He's Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. And now, live from Austin, Texas, Alex Jones.
I saw it a few weeks ago. It's powerful. Rob Jacobson, David Knight, and others put together a review of the Congress dealing with a total Brave New World drugged population dystopia. We're going to play that review coming up at the bottom of the hour. Doug Casey's our guest till 20 after, taking phone calls, the author of The International Man, leading anarchy capitalist libertarian, as you could call him, with a lot of accurate predictions and forecasting. Finish up with Russia, then we're going to go to Phil in Florida. This article from Casey Research, The Russian Empire Strikes Back. How are they striking back with world energy?
Well, one of the guys that I work with, his name is Marin Katusa, fantastic speculator, brilliant young guy, and he's written a book called The Colder War, and I urge your listeners to read that book. He goes into a lot of these things in detail. But going back to Russia for a moment, I'm all for those two breakaway provinces from the Ukraine, Lugansk and Donetsk, just as I was all for the South breaking away from the U.S. During the war between the states. I'd like to see 7 billion little nation states in the world, and the more the merrier. It'll give individuals more control as nation states get smaller. So I want to go the opposite direction of the European Union. I'd like to see 1,000 little countries in Europe. Perhaps one of them might actually be free.
Exactly. Not big, giant super states that are almost always more oppressive, but lots of little states to compete with each other with lower taxes and freedom, creating real diversity.
Precisely. So that there's every reason to support the rebels in those two breakaway provinces in the Ukraine. And the fact that the Russians are on their side and helping them, that's fine. But certainly the United States has no business at all sticking its nose into what's happening in a part of the world that most Americans can't even find on a map.
75% of eastern Ukraine is Russian. About a third of western Ukraine is. For most of its history, as you know, Doug, it's been part of Russia. That's not some Russia-worshipping statement. It's just facts. They've got neocons that call me a Russian agent because I'm against starting war with Russia so George Soros can turn that place into another one of his little palaces where they put five-year-old boys in dresses.
No, exactly, Alex. And Russia is certainly no bastion of freedom, but it is no longer a communist country either. And the top income tax rate in Russia is 10%. That's it, 10%.
Unbelievable.
So in many ways, Russia is now freer than the U.S. is.
If folks only knew, they only ran an operation like a business like I do, because we have to run this as a business to finance it. They just have no idea what a real middle class or nouveau riche entrepreneur goes through. I mean, the taxes are over 80%. You add them all together. Unless you engage in, you know, squirrely stuff like the globalist, and then they selectively enforce against you, where it's hard to do unless you completely leave the country.
Yeah, and I'm very disturbed about the demonization of Russia and China and so many other countries by the U.S. government, because it was Rudolf Steiner that said 100 years ago, "War is the health of the state."
That's right,
and that is so true, because when there's a war, that's the perfect excuse for the state to pass more laws and more restrictions and taxes. So, in general, chaos is the health of the state, not just war. And I'm very anti-war.
That's right. They want chaos so they can orchestrate, run the whole thing, consolidate power, milk it, and then let the chaos continue against their enemies. We're going right to Phil Isaiah, Ron, Ray, Dakota, and others. Straight ahead, bam, 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 your calls with Doug Casey of Casey Research, best-selling author and researcher and well-known successful speculator. We'll be back. Doug Casey of Casey Research is our guest. We're taking phone calls right now, but you hadn't heard that Jamie Foxx clip. We've got a whole group of those with people saying, I don't have to pay for my house or my car anymore. I'll get everything free. You're God. And Obama supporters on the street literally believe that he's like a leprechaun that can give people buckets of gold from nowhere and that it's not being taken from somebody else, Doug.
Well, it's shocking and actually disgusting. And I don't like to call anybody a racist, but perhaps Jamie Foxx is a racist because he's black and Obama's black. I mean, does that have anything to do with
it? It is him. Only white people can be racist. It's been proven by Al Gore, who also invented the planet.
Certainly the internet, anyway.
Yes. Well, there you go. It's anyone that disagrees with us is a racist. If you're against the free market, you're a racist.
If you're against global warming, which I guess Al Gore invented too, you're also a racist. This whole thing about racism, it's just crazy. I mean, of course people are different from each other. And the fact of the matter is that people, birds of a feather, tend to flock together. And the races of people are like breeds of dog. We're different. I mean, Irish setters are good at some things, and poodles are good for others, and bulldogs are good for other things. And vive la différence. If you're a poodle as opposed to a bulldog, it doesn't mean you hate bulldogs. You just recognize the difference.
No, I like bulldogs.
Crazy.
I like bulldogs, and I guess that means I'm racist against all other breeds of dog.
These people keep bringing this up, and it inflames racism. They say they hate racism, but they really must like racism.
Well, that's all they've got. They don't have any real ideas. It's just spew racism all day. Phil in Florida, you're on the air with our guest. Go ahead.
Hey, Alex. Apparently, if you've been able to shed the grease from your public education, then you're a racist.
But, that's right.
I just wanted to thank Mr. Casey for coming on today. I have all the guests that you have on here, and I almost always agree with you 99.9% of the time, but this guy, so far, everything he said is, to me, right on. It's particularly about fascism and the way that the school is, they don't even teach people what fascism is anymore because they want you to think that it's capitalism.
Yeah, no, they want a scapegoat, I agree with you, capitalism, for this crony, fascist, pick-the-winner, insider, gangster system that we're under.
Yes, when you use words inaccurately or incorrectly, it clouds your thought, because if you don't know exactly what a word means, then you can't actually know what you're talking about.
Well, that's what Orwell talked about.
Confused, right? You're right, Alex. Exactly. Love is hate and so forth. Precisely correct.
And he was talking about in that book, Ingsoc, the Fabian Socialists in England that he was part of, how they wanted to destroy the language. When he finally got into their upper groups and he found out they were really just a bunch of criminal predators who wanted to be the only people that could think, that's when Orwell turned against them. Simply amazing. Thank you, Phil. Ron in Canada, you're on the air with Doug Casey.
Yes. Hi, Doug. How are you?
Good. Thanks.
I got a question about propaganda.
Yes.
I'm talking about Edward Bernays. Propaganda is the executive arm of the invisible government. And it also talks about the group mind. If we understand the mechanisms and motives of the group mind, it is now possible to control and regiment the masses according to our will without them knowing it. I want to know about the group mind, if you could talk about that. What is it?
Sure, you're bringing up the 1930s book Propaganda by Edward Bernays, the top psych warfare chief of the statist here in the U.S. Your take just on general hive-minding mob mentality they're trying to engineer into everybody, Doug?
Well, I may be a genetic freak from that point of view, but the fact is all of us tend to run with the herd. If you're the only person in an audience that be quiet about it because the rest of the mob might tear you apart. It's tough to be a contrarian. In the investment world, it's very tough. In the social world, it's very tough. In the intellectual world, it's very tough to think for yourself. It's much easier to just go along with the crowd.